Hello everyone, my name is Mr. Hurricane. Welcome to the final season of the Minnesota Gophers Dynasty. Season 10 is ready to kick off as the Minnesota Gophers face number 17 TCU in this year's season opener. The Gophers have had four straight double-digit win seasons and another big bowl victory last year, led by their dominant defense, which has many juniors returning for their senior seasons. There are high expectations surrounding this team once again. It's time to see what they can do. We'll see this defense first as they face a tough test here in week one. Shane Wood approaches, and off we go in season 10. Booming kick into the end zone, and TCU will take the touchback. Minnesota's run defense was number one last year. And to start this season, they face Maurice Williams, one of the best backs in the nation. TCU opens up twin tight ends and motions one left to right. The deep back is Maurice Williams. Handoff on the first play. Williams fighting through a tackle. It's a first down and more as Williams is up across the 40 for a gain of 18. He has a great power-speed blend that makes him an ideal pro prospect, and the Gophers will have their hands full today. Another give to Maurice Williams, off tackle with space. Another missed tackle, and Williams is out of bounds after a gain of 15. Minnesota's going to need those run-stopping linebackers to step up. Now to the air, TJ Weisbecker looks to scramble, and he's sacked on his first dropback. It's Tony Hunter, who led the team with 9 sacks last season. Second and long, back to Maurice Williams again. First contact, we can't stop him, but then there's Jack after a gain of 4. TCU facing third down. Here comes the blitz. Weisbecker in trouble and sacked. First hit by Eric Lemon, then sacked by Josh Mackey, and the Gopher defense recovers. Now it's our first time seeing this Gopher offense with four brand new offensive line starters. Tim Gallagher in the shotgun on first down. Back to pass, nobody open, and as was Weisbecker, he's sacked on his first drop back. All eyes will be on this Gopher offensive line. Now the first run in, TJ Jackson is stopped for a loss. Gophers going backwards on their first possession. It's 3rd and 16 from their own 5. Inside handoff, a positive play this time as Jackson gets a couple, but the Gophers will still punt from their own end zone. Great start for the TCU defense. Now Dwayne Miller punts it away, and underneath that at his own 43-yard line is Henderson. And Eric Lemon can't make the tackle that allows Henderson to reach the 41 of Minnesota for the new TCU possession. It's a 3-wide look, delayed give. Here's Maurice Williams working outside for about 6 to start this drive. Two tight ends on the field now. Weisbecker back to pass. And wide open is J.J. Brigham, the freshman tight end, left all alone for a gain of 19. Here's the first red zone trip of the season. Weisbecker three-step drop, and his pass is knocked down by Josh Mackey. Good zone defense. Facing a second down, back to the ground. Here's Williams off tackle. Excellent blocking, and he's brought down by Josh Mackey after a gain of 8. They're getting a great push up front and keep it on the ground here on third down, but Williams meets Reggie Carter. They tried the shotgun counter, and Carter made an amazing play. That's why he is the heart and soul of this defense. TCU stalls, but they get a chip shot field goal try and take a 3-0 lead here in the first quarter. We'll see if the Gophers offense looks better on their second try. Back to the air on first down, a swing outside for TJ Jackson, and they just lost 7 to begin this one. Minus 11 yards so far for the Gophers. Now second and long. Gallagher again outside for Jackson. That picks up 5, and it's third down and long. From their own 15, facing a 4-man rush. Gallagher stepping up. He's under pressure. Throws on the move. It's a one-handed catch. First down, Clint Porter. The sophomore comes through big. Gallagher is excellent on the move as he unleashes a little jump pass here, and Porter makes the great play. Now in a 3-wide pistol, it's TJ Jackson who stumbles. Might have been hit by the turf monster as he gets 5. Two tight ends on the field, play fake. Gallagher rolling left, and wide open underneath is Michael Williams. And with the power, he gets the first down. The Gophers want to utilize both Marcus and Michael Williams. On second down, Gallagher floating it outside. There's Jackson again. And now Jackson demonstrating some power as he gets the first down. Already 3 grabs for TJ Jackson. He could play a big role in the pass game this season. Now it's the Gophers power back, Chauncey Thornton, as he gets knocked back with a big hit after a gain of 5. Jackson back in, second down, last play of the first quarter as Jackson follows Marcus Williams and gets 7. Gophers having some success on those counters and now an option with motion, and Gallagher decides not to pitch it back as there were a couple defenders there to meet him. Split backfield now on second and long. Center push back as Gallagher goes down the middle. Nice grab made by Nick Wilkerson. That's good for 11. Same personnel on third and short. And I don't think this was how it was drawn up. Looked like the Gophers wanted to set up some kind of an option, and Thornton ran into Gallagher and kind of put this play in a bad spot. This trio really hasn't played much together. There's a lack of chemistry, certainly. So the drive stalls, but Shane Wood kicks through the field goal to make it 3 apiece. This drive was sparked by that play from Gallagher to Clint Porter. Here in the second quarter, TCU has the football on 1st and 10. Weisbecker looks to scramble. He breaks away from one, but Carter meets him, and it's a 5-yard loss. Carter makes another play. The tight end Brigham in motion on 3rd down. Weisbecker down the middle and complete to Nate Lee, who meets LaShawn Smith at the end, but it's a 1st down. Weisbecker in the shotgun, throwing again, and that was almost picked off. He jumped right in front of it. Come on, Josh Mackey. On 2nd down, Weisbecker goes right back to the air and hits Lee on the outside for another 1st down conversion. They have not shied away from asking Weisbecker to make plays in the pocket. But here he's in some trouble and is sacked again. The Gophers are bringing the pressure. That was John Rice. TCU goes empty on 2nd down. Gophers try to blitz. It doesn't work, and they left a huge void there in the middle of the defense. And Will Anderson converts. Facing a 2nd down and 10, Weisbecker again to the air, and wide open underneath is Gibbons. Big hit by Mackey after a gain of 9. TCU on 3rd and short goes with the pitch. Maurice Williams on the edge gets the 1st down and is brought down at the 20-yard line. 3 tight ends on the field this time. They run that way. Williams breaks another tackle to the 10, and Mackey can't bring him down. It's a touchdown. The strength of Maurice Williams has given TCU a touchdown lead. Minnesota has struggled to tackle him as Williams continues to break first contact. It's going to be a long day for the defense if they can't shore this up. TCU up 10-3 as the Gophers take over. Gallagher to the air. He hits Marcus Williams on 1st down, and this catch is good for 6 or 7. Minnesota got their offense going last possession. Now on 2nd down, it's a keeper. Gallagher very good on the move as he picks up the 1st down. He had 6 rushing touchdowns last year. In a 4-receiver set, it's a handoff on a jet sweep to Lee James. The Gophers will try this once or twice a game. That's 5 yards. Jackson back in the game on 2nd down. Here's the blitz, and Gallagher has Jackson all alone. 1st down and more. He's in TCU territory, doing his best Matt Pierre impression for 19 yards. Now the Gophers go empty and back to the air as Gallagher has Randy Rodriguez underneath. They cleared the middle and left a nice lane for Rodriguez to pick up 15. Fullback Grigsby in the game. It's a toss outside. Jackson to the 15 and falling forward for a couple extra. That's a gain of 4. Inside 2 minutes to go on the half. Gallagher on 2nd down has Marcus Williams once again, just shy of the 1st down marker. Minnesota facing a 3rd down and 1. They keep it on the ground. Jackson is stopped near the marker, and the Gophers are awarded a 1st down. I'm surprised there's no review, but 1st down and goal. Gallagher throwing a jump ball. It's not a very good one. Tipped and caught by Jackson. That was almost an amazing touchdown. I've never seen this before. This was a very poorly thrown jump ball, and the Gophers still almost scored on it. Heads up play by Jackson. Goal line personnel now on the field as Jackson gets the pitch. That's a walk-in touchdown. This game is tied. TJ Jackson had 3 rushing touchdowns last season. It's his year for the feature role, and he's played a big part in the Gopher offense so far. And here he ties the game. Good first half of action as there are 26 seconds left on the clock. TCU is not ready for halftime as Weisbecker throws perfect for Larry Stewart. That's a gain of 22. TCU still has two timeouts. They're trying to get in field goal range. Weisbecker has his pass knocked down by Reggie Carter. 18 seconds now on the clock. Gophers bring three, and Weisbecker complete again to Stewart, this time for seven. Still 15 seconds on the clock as Weisbecker has the screen set up for Maurice Williams. On the edge at the 40, he's brought down. That was a big tackle made by Calvin Hall. 4 seconds on the clock. This has to be quick. Lob downfield, cut by Stewart, and he's out of bounds with 1 second left. TCU brings on the field goal unit. A solid drive there to get them in range, and the kick is good. 13-10, TCU on top at the halfway point. We've seen some good play from Minnesota on both sides of the ball, but it's clear the number one priority has to be to stop Maurice Williams. The second half is now underway. The Gophers have possession while trailing by three. Gallagher stands in the shotgun. He's had a good passing day and has another good throw here as he fits it in to Marcus Williams for 13 yards. It's been a bunch of short throws for Minnesota, and they've mixed in some option as Gallagher on another keeper picks up the first down, this time for 12. It's a wildcat look. We haven't seen this much. And a jet sweep. Here goes Brandon Jones, the speedster. But TCU does a good job containing him to only 4 yards. Gallagher back at quarterback. Empty shotgun on second down. But pressure there. The ball is out. And TCU has recovered. That's one of the biggest concerns this year. How will the offensive line hold up? Here they just cost the Gophers a possession. This happened right as Lee James was breaking wide open. TCU's defense has made one of the biggest plays of the game, and Maurice Williams has nowhere to go as Vincent Walker steps up with a big play. Now on third down, Weisbecker back to pass, and he throws a dart to the outside to Gibbons. Perfect throw by Weisbecker, and it's first and 10. Deep back is Williams. He takes this off tackle inside the 5 to the goal line. And he's ruled out at the 1. Williams didn't quite get his second touchdown, but from the 1, they give it right back to him, and this time he breaks the plane. Touchdown, Horned Frogs. They've opened up a 2-score lead, capitalizing on Minnesota's first turnover. It's 20-10, and the Gophers need some fixes on both sides of the ball. The kick sails deep. Here's Brandon Jones from the end zone. He takes it up the numbers through a lane. Jones to the 40, and he's brought down at the 45-yard line, but it gives the Gophers great field position. They open up split shotgun and go to the ground. It's Chauncey Thornton through a lane, and Thornton has a gain of 9. Two receivers right. On second and short against the blitz, it's a check down to TJ Jackson. Can't make a man miss, but he does break the tackle eventually and gets 11 yards. Jackson has 6 grabs in this game. With a new set of downs, another blitz, and Gallagher goes outside to Marcus Williams for another first down. Minnesota nearing the red zone. Here comes James in motion. Gallagher running an option, and it's going to be stopped once again. The defender attacks that outside arm, and he doesn't want to risk the pitch. On third down and 11, TCU sends some heat. Gallagher trying to stay in the pocket, and he goes down. TCU swarming on third down with Zach Rivers recording his second sack. Once again, this happened as James was breaking free. The Gophers are still in field goal range as Shane Wood's strong leg has made it a 7-point game once again. But can the Gopher defense keep TCU from scoring? Weisbecker on first and 10 starts this drive looking to scramble, and the Gophers blitz pays off. Sacked by Calvin Hall. TCU goes empty on third down. Weisbecker down the middle, complete to Stewart, but there's Vincent Walker denying him the first down. That's a 3 and out. Big stop for Minnesota. Now they take over. First down, Gallagher underneath. It's tipped and almost picked off. It went right through the hands of Nick Wilkerson. We're lucky that wasn't a TCU touchdown. Gallagher on third down, but pressure again, and down he goes. Another sack on Tim Gallagher. It's Sam Singleton. The teams trade 3 and outs, and TCU takes over shy of their 40. Play fake. Weisbecker from the pocket going deep. A man breaks free. Basket catch by Stewart. And in one play, TCU gets into scoring range. It looked like Ronnie Osborne lost track of the receiver. On 1st and 10, Williams gets the carry, and he takes TCU inside the 20. Facing 3rd and 6, it's another play action. Weisbecker lobbing to the sideline, and Gibbons steps out. Gophers catch a huge break there. TCU won't get another touchdown, but this field goal does make it a two-score game again. Minnesota now trailing by 10 with 16 seconds to go in the third quarter. On 1st and 10, Gallagher dumps it off, and Jackson has nowhere to go. Maybe a gain of 1. And that's going to take us to the fourth quarter. Gophers facing a 2nd down and 9 from their own 20-yard line. From the empty set, Gallagher going deep. He has a man open downfield. Caught by Wilkerson inside the 10. And Nick Wilkerson is in for the touchdown. That was Gallagher's first time testing this defense deep. They played a cover 2 zone. And the Gophers had 2 receivers go deep on that side. What a huge play for Minnesota, but they still need their defense to step up. TCU opens up 3 wide. Weisbecker throws and is picked off by Reggie Carter. He's inside the 25 to the 15 and stopped near the 10. We are just seconds into the fourth quarter, and Minnesota is flipping this entire game. The captain of this defense, Reggie Carter, is the one who makes the play. The Gophers are back in the red zone. Gallagher to the air. Good coverage, however. He rolls outside the pocket and will take off and maybe get a couple yards. TCU trying to protect their lead. It's 3rd and 9. They send 5. Gallagher staying in the pocket, and eventually time runs out. Great coverage in the end zone, and TCU will force a field goal. This to tie the game. From left hash, Shane Wood's kick is good. 23 apiece here in the fourth quarter, as Minnesota has quickly put up 10 points. TCU hoping to get back on track. Weisbecker again to the air, trying to scramble, and he can't escape Greg Kelly. It's a loss of 1, and Weisbecker is shaken up. Now in the game is backup quarterback Daniel Roth. Throwing for the first time, Roth tries to check it down, and his pass is knocked away by Vincent Walker. Roth now in the shotgun on 3rd and long. He tries to throw to the outside and misses his mark, and TCU will punt. Minnesota's offense back on the field here in this tie game. Hand off inside, it's Jackson through a lane, and he picks up 12 to move the chains. And a 3-wide look from the shotgun, Gallagher fakes. Now rolling left to dump it off to Marcus Williams, who fights ahead for an extra yard or 2, 5 yards. Big 3rd down here for Minnesota. They need 5, and Gallagher has it. 1st down, Nick Wilkerson at the TCU 30. The Gophers now in field goal range can take their time. Here's a bubble screen that goes off the hands of Jackson, and he had green. TCU goes single high safety. Gallagher right back to the air, and he throws on target to Clint Porter. It's a 1st down for Minnesota, and Porter is shaken up. Great execution on this play from Gallagher to Clint Porter, but now Porter will have to leave the game. Brandon Jones now in the game. On 2nd down, Gallagher complete to Lee James. Nice grab, shy of the 1st down marker. It's 3rd down and short. Twins right, 2 tight ends. Play fake on 3rd and 1. Gallagher dumps it off, and it's incomplete. Knocked away by Richardson, and that brings on Shane Wood once again. To give Minnesota the lead, his kick is good. 26-23, Gophers. Can this Gopher defense protect the lead? It's 1st and 10. Here's the blitz. Down goes Roth. It's Reggie Carter. His 2nd sack on the day to go with his interception. Right up the middle untouched. And for TCU, they won't have Weisbecker back in this game. He's been ruled out. Daniel Roth downfield has a man there, and it's incomplete. Broken up by Ronnie Osborne. Roth is 0-for-3 in the air. Now 3rd and 14, it's a screen. Roth out to Williams, looking for a block. He gets it, but goes out of bounds. He tried keeping it outside, and that cost him. Minnesota now trying to put this game away. They've done this with the running game so much in the past, and a great start to this drive as Jackson gets 14. Another 3-wide look. 2 linemen pull, and Jackson is down in the backfield. He ran into his own man. Loss of 2. On 2nd and 12, another pulling lineman as Jackson runs right, trying to break free. He gets 9. Minnesota can win the game with a first down here. Another handoff to Jackson. He has room. First down. He goes down. And the Gophers are 1-0. What an amazing fourth quarter for Minnesota as they come back down 10 points. They erase that deficit in a hurry. And they start the season with a 26-23 victory. The first play of the fourth quarter was Nick Wilkerson's 80-yard touchdown. The second play of the fourth quarter was Reggie Carter's interception. TCU essentially handed us this victory. That cover two against our spread look wasn't a good idea, and their pass-first approach throughout the game definitely backfired. We never really contained Maurice Williams. He only carried the ball 14 times, while TCU passed it 24 times. The big reason why was because TCU felt the need to pass on 1st and 10. We sacked them 7 times. We did a good job forcing 3rd and longs, and that kept the ball out of Williams' hands. But I'm amazed they did not give him the ball more. Reggie Carter's clutch interception was huge, and that was being set up throughout the game. Josh Mankey had a pair of deflections, Reggie Carter had 1 in man coverage, and still, they threw it at our linebackers, and eventually, the captain of the defense made the biggest play for us. Reggie Carter is the defensive player of the week, very deservingly so. In the top 25, the biggest upset this week was Auburn beating LSU and dropping them from 9 to 19. Otherwise, not much changed in the standings, as most teams don't play in week 1 for reasons that are beyond my knowledge. But in week 2... the Gophers are back on the field to take on UAB. We faced them at home last season, which became our first and only shutout in this series, as the Gophers won 9-0. This time we travel to face UAB, and we'll see Aaron Higdon once again. For Minnesota, there are no injuries heading into this game, as Clint Porter is good to go for week 2. And I'm excited to see Minnesota face Aaron Higdon one more time. Thank you all for watching. That is it for week 1, as season 10 kicked off on the right note. Minnesota scores a big victory over number 17 TCU, and we'll see them again soon against UAB. Please leave a like if you enjoyed the episode. Comment below your thoughts on the season opener, which players impressed you the most in this come from behind victory, and subscribe if you have not done so already. I'll see you guys next time. Have a great day.